Don't get too excited, they're not mine. Hey, what's good, guys? My name's Chris. Welcome back to the official WearTesters.com YouTube channel. Today, we got something pretty cool. We got these bad boys right here and these cool two-pack undefeated collab with the Kobe shoe or whatever for Mamba Week. Is that what it was? Was it a whole week of L's? Just a whole week of letdowns? That's what it felt like. I put in with however many emails I had and I couldn't get a single one. I tried. I really did. I was literally on the app, like the sneakers app, at the thing, cart, everything, you're in line, whatever, just kidding. You don't touch. So funny, he wasn't ready. So yeah, all you people with your bots and all that stuff, congratulations. I'm glad that you screwed actual fans over. But despite all that, a friend of mine actually was able to get a pair of these, or obviously the pairs, the box set. And so he let me borrow them and we're gonna talk about them. I'm not gonna put them on feet or anything, but I really like the changes that they made to the shoe. I feel like this is like gonna be a better performance shoe if anybody has the balls to actually hoop in these. Would I have had I won these? Because I entered the raffle twice with two emails. Actually, all of us at Wear Testers, every single member of Wear Testers tried for these. Staff member, nobody got a pair. Would I have hooped in these had I won them? Yeah, man, these are cool. What else are you supposed to do in Kobe's? I thought everybody said these aren't lifestyle shoes.
That's true.
Didn't they all say that? They did, I swear. Now, this one right here is my favorite of the two. However, this is gonna be the one that ages the worst. It's all white, it's mesh, it's got polyurethane, it's got fuse, it's got clear soles. These are gonna turn super yellow. Man, but they look good right now. They just do. I really love this back. I love that. That's probably like the coolest thing that they've done besides add the snake scales from the Kobe 6. Did you notice that?
I did.
Oh, you did? Okay. Yeah, so like what they have here, I don't know if this is an actual play on the original 5s because it's kind of in the back, but even then, like this is a different material than this. This is more of a Cordura mesh or a ballistic style mesh, what you would see on the Air Jordan 11. While it's similar to this collar panel, it's not the same. So this reduces the weight a little bit compared to the plastic fuse, but if I'm like holding both in hand, actually these have the little stuffing. Let me take that out. These might be still a little bit lighter. This is one of the lightest basketball shoes ever. Not the lightest, but it's one of them. This does feel a little bit more substantial. I think it's because there's extra stitching and padding and all that stuff. The swooshes are different. This is all like a shell. And this guy is, again, more of a, I don't want to call it traditional build, but it's built more like a shoe than the original one. These ones, this fuse stuff when they first came out was super interesting. The skin fuse is the best versions where it actually flexes well. The original Hyperfuse was mad stiff.
That's what she said.
When it had this weird popping sound when you would walk in it. These ones don't have that. But I absolutely love the changes. I just feel like it's like going to be a beast of a shoe on court. I really like that ballistic style mesh. I love the placement of the polyurethane scales, man. Like that is so slick because it's right in the flex zone. And so they made it that super lightweight mesh with the scales on top of it to try to protect the material while also giving it that cool Mamba feel. And it doesn't hurt that the Kobe 6 is probably like my favorite Kobe of all time. I just absolutely love these. You can check this video right here. Shameless plug all day. I know, it's all good. But yeah, and I really like the swoosh too. Like the, just the added thing to it. It's something so like small or whatever, but I like it. And then I like that they kept the fuse on the toe, even though this one got a little discolored. I just still think that that's the callback to the Kobe 5 other than the actual model itself, where it's like, okay, they use original materials a little bit, but then they beefed everything else up. And I just really like that. I assume they fit true to size. These are not mine, so I'm not gonna put them on, but the Kobe 5 Protro, I should say, did fit true to size in my opinion. So that's what I would go with. As far as tech specs go, the original shoe, these guys right here, they have a Phylon midsole, and then they have a met bag in the forefoot. And the met bag is a zoom unit, but it's only that big. It just covers the ball of the foot. It's literally right there in that little spot. And then they have a normal size, not normal size, but normal shape. It's like that U shape right there in the heel, and it's a slightly larger volume. These mag comfy even today, because these are OGs and stuff. And thank goodness the air is still intact, because that usually pops eventually. The Protro version is Kushlon, so the entire midsole is Kushlon, and then the forefoot cushion, they took out the met bag and they put in a Zoom Turbo unit, what you would find in the Kyrie 5 and 6. And the forefoot in these feels awesome. The Kushlon feels good too. When I was playing in them though, and even when I wear them casually, I do feel like the Kushlon is a little soft, so I feel like I sink back a little bit. I felt like this in the 4 Protro as well, and that's when I tore my calf. I was wearing those that day, and then I like played again that night, and my calf tore, and I feel like it was because I was sinking, and it feels like it stresses out that whole back area of my leg, my calf, my Achilles. I don't recommend hooping these a lot unless you're like real strong, but to me, that's what I attribute my calf tear to, the Kobe 4 Protro. I know, and I don't normally blame stuff like that on shoes, but that's one of those things. Also, that I overused the shit out of my legs. That was probably the main thing. I could feel the stress in them from when I wear this stuff, and it's because the forefoot is firmer than the back, which is really weird, and it just has that weird, like, sink feeling. I don't know if anybody else notices it or not, but, you know, I know a lot of NBA guys wear these just fine. They also have great trainers and great staff that keep them in tip-top shape, and I have myself in an elastic band. Now, as far as the undefeated thing goes, they obviously have their branding on there. They got that cool little patch in the back of the tongues, and it's also got Kobe's logo on it. It's on the box. It's on one of the insoles, which is dope. But I really like those that the other insole, they're a little bit different. This one actually has the 13th place. This one only goes from 1 through 12. But in the draft, he was picked 13th overall by Charlotte. It says that here. This one, it stops at 12 at Cleveland. It also does the same thing in the inside with the paper. So all of that stuff right there. So it's a little callback to his start in the league. I didn't read any press information. I believe, though, that this is supposed to represent Charlotte, hence the teal. And then this is what I assume is all the teams that passed his ass up, because they just have all of the colors in there, so I just feel like it is. And yes, I will probably get some idiot in the comment section being like, you're dumbass, you should have read stuff, blah, blah, blah. How are you gonna be a reviewer? I don't need to read stuff to know his heritage, man. I've been watching Kobe since he was drafted, man. I just know this. So yeah, I think that these came out really, really nice. Again, this is my favorite of the two, although those are cool too for that, like, what the colorway. I just noticed that the tongues are not the torch material. They're the ballistic mesh. I don't like that. I would rather have had the torch. I love Nike torch material. They should use that on every shoe. I'm just saying.
Just do it!
Out of these two, do you have a preference?
I don't know.
I don't know if you're an actual, like, when you see a Kobe shoe, I don't know if it does anything for you.
Ooh.
If that wasn't sarcasm, I don't know what is.
I don't know. Like you were talking about the white one, these things are going to be...
They're going to look so bad so fast, but they look so cool right now.
They do. But I mean, just even walking...
Toast.
Dirt
yeah.
Puffs up off the floor.
Toast, man. The bottom's going to yellow. The top's going to yellow. The scales are going to yellow. The mesh is going to yellow. Like these things. It's going to be one big ass yellow shoe. Give it 10 years.
Yeah.
You know, unless you store them like so well and stuff. This one will obviously last a little bit longer.
I do like things about this one though. I like how it's like a patchwork quilty type thing. The extra little stitching to it.
I like all those little details.
I love that maroon tongue, but that's because I'm a sucker for maroon.
I knew that you were going to like that part. It's a shame that that's the only piece of maroon on these.
Yeah.
You know, where I was like, man, you could have really done like the maroon panel and then still kept the blue. I would have liked a little bit more of a real mix up, but overall, I just think that it turned out real well. My favorite drop from the Mamba Week stuff, though, was the kind of, it almost reminded me of these, the new Laker colorway. But that was the one that I really wanted. I tried to get the one that launched first just because it launched at a time that I was like, really? Like, I don't have to wake up at 7? Launched at like 11 o'clock, and so I was like, might as well try. And that was the one where I was like, man, I just know. Literally, like, I was there like 5 minutes before, and I'm in line or whatever, and at 9 o'clock, or not 9 o'clock, 11 o'clock on the dot, I took the L. And I was like, how did you sell out at the time that they released?
I just like to imagine that you guys are a bunch of those little Wii emojis standing in a room waiting for,
like, digitally.
Yeah. And like, you guys are all popping up, and then all of a sudden it's time, and you're like, oh, I gotta get in line. And everybody just goes...
Well, it's funny because that's probably what it looks like on the interwebs.
Yeah.
Like if you're going to go like Wreck-It Ralph style and go like into the internet.
Matrix.
Yes. So I'm sure that it's got all the wee idiots that are just me and everybody else on my phone and shit. And then all of a sudden all the bots go boof, and they just buy everything. And everybody's like, oh man, what the hell?
It's totally Wreck-It Ralph.
That's what I'm saying. Like I'm just, that's what it feels like. So yeah, I'm just, I'm kind of over it personally. Like sneakers are something that I love. And something that I'm passionate about, but the way that everything works nowadays, it's just, it really sucks the life out of you. And I would rather not pay attention to press releases and stuff like that, because why get excited for no reason? Like, I know that I'm not gonna win these. Sneakers are one of the few things where you have the money and it doesn't matter. It's like, oh, you're gonna release this, I'm ready. And the brand's like, that's nice. Like,
that's cute.
Yeah, exactly. Like, we don't care. So that's just kind of like what it feels like. So yeah, so I'm in this state where I see a drop or an upcoming drop and I'm like, oh, that's cool. But then I immediately am like, I know I ain't gonna get that unless I pony up, and I'm not trying to pony up. Like, I can go buy a video game for retail price. I can go pre-order an action figure for retail price. Why am I jumping through hoops? Like, why does Nike make us do this? So I'm just kind of over it. But that pretty much takes care of it for these guys. Again, I think that they did a great job on the shoe itself. I think that they look fantastic. Hopefully the next drops are a little bit more attainable for regular folks. Again, if you were able to get a pair, congrats. Hopefully you're not reselling them. And if you are,
shame on you.
Well, I was going to say do you, but shame on you too. You know what I mean? Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for all the support. Let us know what you thought about these, if you're able to get them or not. If you did get them, what are you doing with them? Are you selling them? Are you wearing them? Are you hooping in them? I'd like to know. Thanks once again. Until next time, guys. Have a good one.